I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. And he walks with me, and he talks with me, and he tells me I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry there
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A promise was made to our sister on the day of her baptism, that if she would die with the Lord in the waters of baptism, she would rise to eternal life with him in the resurrection. It's a promise we remember with great hope today as we bring our sister's remains and commend them to the Lord. With our prayer, he fulfilled that promise. The day of her baptism, she received a white garment that was an outward sign of her dignity in that baptism. A dignity we remember with this garment.
Thank you.
visiting with us this afternoon at this table. You honor us with your presence. I know that you bring comfort to this family, and I hope you find comfort in the sorrow that you must feel in the passing of this very good woman. Whatever our religious beliefs or spirituality, if we can believe that there is a power in this universe from which all things came and to whom all things are returning, then in this moment, for our sister, we can be one in prayer. Loving God, we pray in thanksgiving for a good life lived by a good person. We pray in thanksgiving for the love that her family and nursing care showed to her, and all of those who supported her as her life grew weak. She's an inspiration about how life should be lived with all of our energy and all of our intelligence, so that exploring this world as it is, we might come to know you and your love for us even more intensely. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak to the heart of Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service has ended, that her guilt is expiated, that she has received from the hand of the Lord. A voice proclaims, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, every mountain and hill made low. The rugged land shall be a plain for the rough country and broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, proclaim. I answer, what shall I proclaim? All flesh is grass, and all their loyalty like flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower wilts, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Yes, the people is grass. The grass withers, the flower wilts, but the word of our God stands forever. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of good news. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Cry out. Do not fear. Say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Did you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God. He created the remotest parts of the earth. He does not grow tired or weary. His understanding is beyond fathoming. He gives strength to the weary. He strengthens the powerless. Youth grow tired and weary. The youth stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will regain their strength and will sprout wings like eagles. Though they run, they will not grow weary. Though they walk, they will never tire. The word of the Lord.
Thank you. From the second letter of Paul to Timothy, I charge you in presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have completed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance, the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Lord, you are. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who were persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What a remarkable 8 decades this woman had. An athlete all through her life. A figure skater early on. You know, young people make mistakes, and the only flaw I've seen in this nice woman's life was she fell in love with someone from Georgia Tech. It was disgusting. She was ice skating, he was practicing ice hockey. I mean, this could make a movie. They married, very happy. She lost him early. They had 4 neat kids who were filled with affection and love and ready to give it to even strangers. She loved God's nature, gardening. She loved people, was very grateful for those who cared for her and watched over her. I never ran up Kennesaw Mountain, but I grew up not far from there, and I walked up it many times. And not her. She ran up the damn mountain. Why anybody would do that, running down, I could understand. She was an athlete. She obviously was a loving mom who loved her kids. Good family. Nieces, nephews, good family. A full 8 decades. But my bet is it was exhausting. And she was tired. And that demonic disease that gets so many of us, cancer, broke her spirit and her body, not her heart. But you get tired in life. When you hurt, when you've filled your bucket list with almost everything there is to put in it. And as you get older, and I'm in a position to realize this, you start looking at, okay, it's great, but what more is there? You begin to realize this world offers so many beautiful opportunities and challenges, and grab a hold of it. When you're young, get it by the tail, swing it around, and enjoy it. But it's not the sum total of our existence. I love the reading we see now is through a glass darkly. We can't even begin to imagine what is waiting for us on the other side. And thank God for that faith. Because there is a certain disillusionment one comes to in this life, and you say, jeepers, is this it? Especially when things seem to go wrong like they seem to be doing right now. A person with spirit like your mom has sees beyond all of that to the power of life. Fully lived. Fully loved. And the more you live life, the more you look toward the fulfillment of life. That's our faith. If anybody's up there in heaven, mom is. Skating, running, gardening, in a perfect creation. not half perfect, but a perfect creation. We believe in the communion of saints, which basically says that those who have gone before us, your mom, they still love us. Death doesn't break that love and that heart connection. And she will stay in your life. I lost my parents early, and believe me, there have been many times when I've heard, attaboy, son. And there have been many times when I've heard, Patrick, we taught you better. My guess is you'll continue to hear that voice too. Just be thankful. You had her for a long time. She instilled her goodness and love of life in each of you. And that gift keeps giving and giving and giving so that you can turn around and pass the gift given to you by her to the family that surrounds you. I commend you for your choice of readings. I saw the direct connection between every one of those readings in the life of your mom. There's another one that you'll find engraved on this building and on the one across the driveway too, because at one time I was pastor here and I could do those kind of things. It's maybe one of my favorites. I believe I shall see the good things of the Lord in the land of the living. She didn't have to believe that anymore. She sees it. Now let us stand and pray the petitions the family brought for us to pray today.
Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church, confident that God heard the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus. We join our prayers to his. In baptism, Gloria received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Gloria, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those family members and friends who were sick, that they may receive God's comfort and healing, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For Gloria's husband, Maurice, Gloria's son, Danny, and other loved members of her family, that they may be welcomed into God's glory, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all of us assembled here and virtually to worship in faith, that we may be gathered again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For those in public office and service, that they may promote world peace, security, and justice for all, especially for those who don't have a voice, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Father, we pray in thanksgiving for our sister, for her zest for life. And we pray that each of us who are privileged to know her might inherit that zest, that love of life, living in such a way as she did to inspire people to appreciate every precious moment of our time here, even as we look forward to being reunited with you forever in the kingdom of God. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
down, and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come and my heart burden me, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am stronger when I am on a shoulder. You raise me up to more than I can be. There is no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so imperfectly. But when you come and I am filled with wonder, sometimes I think I glimpse eternity. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am stronger when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. You raise me up to more than I can be.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his
hope. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant, our sister Gloria. On this, her funeral day, we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to her, or any human fault affected her, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. We ask this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts, and let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord, in him the hope of the blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. For indeed, Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for us in heaven. And so with the angels and archangels, the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
indeed holy, O Lord, and all that you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus the Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which we've given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup and once more, giving you thanks, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you, for all people, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the gift of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed us to be reconciled to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by his body and blood may be filled with this Holy Spirit and become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, blessed apostles, the glorious martyrs, and all the saints in whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. And may this sacrifice of reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and peace your pilgrim church on earth, your servant Pope Francis, our Bishop Gregory with his assistants, the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. And listen graciously to the family you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And remember your servant, our sister Gloria, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who is united with your Son in a death like his may be one with him in his resurrection, when from this earth he will raise up the flesh of those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To all of our departed brothers and sisters, all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance into your kingdom. For there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes, and seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages and praise you without end through Christ our Lord, to whom you bestow on this world all that is good. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Take the hand of your brother or sister, and let us pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words our Savior has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
We're running away to a little town called Emmaus. And a stranger came up and said, you guys look off like you've lost your best friend. We have, they said. Are you the only one in Jerusalem who has not heard of the terrible things that happened there today. What terrible things, as he asked. They took our teacher, our rabbi, arrested him on trumped up charges, beat him, crucified him, locked his body in a grave. Now the body's missing. We know who's going to get blamed, and we are out of here. The stranger walked with them and comforted them, as I bet you've tried to comfort each other, especially with scripture passages from Isaiah. And before they knew it, they had reached that little house they were running to in Emmaus. And they said, please come in and join us for dinner. I can't, he said. I've got things I have to do. Please, you've made us feel so much better. Please, come in. Okay. He walked in the house, sat down at table, broke bread. And all of a sudden, those followers said, this wasn't a stranger. This was the Lord. He's risen from the dead. They did not recognize his body on the road. They recognized the risen Christ in the breaking of the bread. And ever since then, we who so desperately need the love and reassurance and the embrace of that risen Christ gathered at a table like this, broken bread and passed a cup, which we too have recognized as no stranger. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sin of the world. And blessed are those who are called the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
gentle woman, quiet light, morning star, so strong and bright, gentle mother, peaceful dove, teach us wisdom, teach us love. You were chosen by Father, you were chosen for the Son, you were chosen from old heaven and for woman, shining. Blessed are you among women, blessed in turn all women's womb. Blessed pray with peaceful spirits, blessed close to you, to one another, and
and to our sister Gloria, as we are in this moment of Holy Communion. We pray this in Jesus' name. She practiced her ice skating skills at Athens instead of in Atlanta. She might have met a George guy. It's a shame. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our farewell express our affection. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. For one day we shall joyfully greet her again with the love of Christ, which conquers all things, conquers even death itself. The celebration of this good woman's life continues in the social hall immediately following this funeral, and you're invited to go up and share some refreshments, memories, and support for one another. The Lord be with you.
Yes.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord one another.
Thanks.
This is the day. This is the day. This is the day. This is the day that
the right.